There's always spirited enthusiasm for a good shot, and the opponents, well, they're a pretty friendly bunch.
You're going to like it.
And that, in a nutshell, is lawn bowling. It's a gentle game, the traditional whites crisp and cool against the impeccably manicured greens. The bowls tossed with a certain elegance and flair. Discussions over scoring are civil affairs. After all, it's a polite game. You chat with the other team. You don't pound them into submission.
It's a courtesy game. You shake hands before, you shake hands after. You applaud good shots. If your opponent makes a bad shot, which means hits the jack to your ball counter, and you clap, that's a no-no.
The game may be polite, but there's keen competition here, too. Today, it's a round-robin tournament for the members of the Sherwood Lawn Bowling Club, and the difference between winning and losing isn't much. The technique begins with the stance and the all-important delivery, putting the spin and weight on the ball, hoping to draw close to the jack.
It's a strategy game. Each person has a bowl, and they deliver it to the jack at 75 or beyond. After you deliver your bowl, when it comes to a rest, you see who is at the closest to the jack after the four bowls are in per bowler.
There's a lot of strategics involved in it. You gotta bring in your ball, and you gotta work with your partner. Like, you have to make shots to set him up and the other way around.
The bowlers here will tell you it's a lot like curling, and like that game, lawn bowling too came from Great Britain. It was the pastime of princes, a garden game for royalty, and when it filtered down to lesser mortals, it was the elderly that took it up in a big way. But now things are different. Young faces mix easily with the old. The traditions are changing, and there are some fresh reasons to play the grand old game.
Hospitality, fresh air, enjoyment.
It's something to do. It's interesting. It's difficult, like I'm not very good at it.
Personally, I took it up for the exercise, the fresh air, the sociability, and travel.
The bull weaves its path, the jack skitters off, the appraisals are made, and another game is started. But this lawn bowling club, perhaps unwittingly, symbolizes the two faces of lawn bowling today. Earl Rod's been playing for years. He takes the game easily. For him, it's a pastime, something he's devoted to.
76, so, you know, it is an old people's game, but I don't know why, because there's all kinds of exercise being made out of this, you know. I can't see why it is.
What do you like best about it?
Oh, I think it's exercise. Yeah, you know, and the competition that you get, especially when you get triples and spares all in together.
It seems like a pretty friendly game.
It is. Everybody's friendly because it's just a game, you know, and it's for sport, so it doesn't make much difference. You know, as long as you have a good game with you, it's in yourself. See, you want to have a good game for yourself as well as for the team.
But doing well for self and team is the part of lawn bowling that's now growing. There are more tournaments now than ever. And for people like Libba Moggs, that means a chance to compete. She recently won a silver in singles play at the Nationals in Vancouver.
So I played off for first the silver medal, and I beat Alberta in that game, and then I played off for gold or silver against BC, and I lost that game, and I ended up second place, which I was very pleased with that. It's my first time in singles. It's not my first time in Nationals. I've been away several times, but it was quite an experience.
But even here, the new face of lawn bowling relies heavily on its old traditions. In the gentle game, competition isn't as important as the people you're playing with.
I think the people I meet. Yeah, I'm a real people's person. Like, I just love meeting new people. You know, I've made a lot of good friendships, the sportsmanship, and it's just a fantastic game.
Okay, that looks good.
In Sherwood, I'm Mark Daly for Compass.